Not only can you use these trigger zones and these trigger areas to trigger camera-based activities to happen, but because you have at your disposal the full might of the control engine that's integrated into that core processor, it means that you can effectively use vision to trigger almost anything. So if you wanted a scenario where, you know, the presenter, you want the presenter's lighting to change when he walks in a specific area, you can do that with a given trigger zone. You can also have a scenario where that person walks in front of a display and then that display automatically turns on. Effectively, you can use that control engine to do whatever you can imagine as long as it's connected to Q-SYS, regardless of how juvenile that might be. And that kind of brings me to the very last scenario here. I'm gonna put a disclaimer out. We're not recommending that you do this. Obviously, cameras don't work in the dark, and there's really no useful application for what you're about to see aside from making me smile every time I watch it. So, Kevin, if you don't mind, can you show us what that looks like?
So we've enabled a trigger zone here on our display. And when I come up, we see now it caused the video to pop up. We had Q-SYS girl come up and she's telling me, hey, I need to go get a drink. Sounds like you're getting a little raspy in the voice. So I'm gonna go over to that bridge zone and trigger it.